Welcome to FirstFleet tenFour.
Hi, folks, and welcome to the FirstFleet tenFour podcast. I'm Austin Henderson. I am with the technology team here in Murfreesboro, and I have got a co-host today, Rebecca Wilson.
Hey, Austin. Thanks for having me here today. This is new territory for me, but excited about it.
Glad to have you here. Rebecca, why don't you tell us just a little bit about what you've done for FirstFleet and your history here and the kind of work that you do every day.
Okay. So I've been here for several years, 28 years, I believe, maybe a little more. I've been a part of different aspects of the company starting early on in my career. And as I've transitioned over the years through projects of TMW and now platform science, lots of exciting things coming up in the next few years. But typically just projects and anything new coming on, I get to be in charge of.
Yeah, I would say in the last 20 years I've been here, we haven't done a project that you haven't in some way influenced, and most of them greatly influenced. You've been in charge of keeping us on task and identifying problems, and so I'm grateful to have you here with us today and grateful that you're a coworker.
Yeah, thank you.
It's encouraging to have you. So we're kicking off this podcast talking a little bit about July the 4th weekend. Historically, this has been a fairly high traffic weekend. I was doing a little bit of reading. AAA is indicating that they think that the travel is going to be down this year, but even though it's going to be down, it's still going to be substantially more of an increase over a typical weekend volume. So why does that matter? It matters to our driver community because we know many of you, men and women who are listening to this podcast, are going to be on the roads this weekend. So we want you to be safe out there, just like every weekend, obviously. But in this case, watch out for additional traffic on the road. There probably will be some additional volumes. I just want you to have a mindset that's aware of that and aware of the other drivers that are on the road and recognizing that they're all probably going to be in a hurry to get where they're going. So just do what you can and keep your eyes out, and let's try to have a good and safe weekend. As we think about the 4th of July weekend, maybe a little bit of a personal note here. I'm going to talk a little bit about some 4th of July traditions. I know some people probably have some things that go back generations in their family, some maybe some new traditions. For me, you know, my family is probably a lot like many of you listening. We get together with friends and some other folks of our family, and we do some grilling, do a little reflection on our freedoms. And I think about my grandfather. My grandfather was made a career out of military service, and he was in several conflicts and worked his whole life really as a man of the military. And so I'm really grateful for that. My grandfather is no longer with us, so I can't really thank him directly. But I do have some neighbors, husband and wife team, that they've made a career out of service to their country. And so generally I give them a call, I text them, I say thanks, I go over and, you know, shake their hands and just let them know I appreciate it. They've given a whole lot for our country to keep us safe, and I want them to hear from, at least from me, that I don't take it for granted. You know, what kind of things do you guys do at your house, Rebecca? What's going on in the Wilson family this weekend?
Well, typically we like to travel, be at the beach or the lake, but due to the slowdown and everybody staying at home, distancing, we will be at home, probably grill out. It's kind of common with what everybody does. I think about our business and the bread business.
Yeah.
Lots of the bakeries are busier than normal, getting to us the buns
and cranking those buns out.
Yeah. And with a smile, I think about Mike Radford.
Yeah.
And we lost Mike Radford a couple months ago, and he was a very important leader in this company, and he was a veteran.
The bread man.
He was the bread man, and we had our conference calls on Tuesday, the week leading up to the holiday, and I can hear him saying, you know, go out and buy those buns. And
watch out for those brown and serve.
That's right. So just a shout out to honor Mike Radford, losing him. But he was important, and those bakeries are busy right now, and we're grateful for our truckers that are getting those items to our groceries.
Absolutely. You know, speaking about that, I know there's a lot of folks on our team that are on the road this weekend, and I know that your celebration may look a little different than some folks who aren't professional drivers for a living. So I just want to say thanks. We appreciate the hard work and the efforts and the energy that you dedicate and you put into what you do every day. So this weekend will be no different for you in that respect. So, but we do hope wherever you are, you get to take a moment and just pause and reflect and really enjoy and celebrate the freedoms that we have. I know there's a lot of you that are listening that you yourself have in some way served in the military or your family is somehow connected to it. So we just want to say thanks as well for that. the nation really, we owe you a great debt of gratitude to the men and women who have carried this burden and have allowed us to be able to enjoy the freedoms that we have. Another question we have here is, what are you most thankful for about living in this country? So I think I'm really most thankful that we, the people, collectively make up this country. And over we've seen that this country can rise and meet the challenges that we face. I'm thankful, really, together, that we can change things and that our future, it can be better than our past. So really, when I'm thinking about this weekend, I'm thinking about, how can I be a peacemaker? How can I strive for unity? And remember that we, the people, we make up this nation. It came with a very heavy price, and the freedoms that we have, they're not to be taken for granted. So I know, when you think about something you're grateful for this weekend, what would you think about, Rebecca?
Well, for sure, I tell you, I'm thankful for my freedom of speech, mm-hmm. and I'm thankful for just being able to be in a job every day. I'm thankful to be in the trucking business for sure. We have been able to continue to stay busy, and I know Eliz was talking a little bit earlier about our roadways and how lucky we are to have the roads that we have. Mm-hmm. And so as a trucking company, to be out there every day, it's our job to be safe, but I think it's important that we are aware of our road system, that it's much better than those in other countries. Mm-hmm. And so be thankful for our police.
Yeah, absolutely.
I do think that that's something right now, that there's so much out there, so much uncertainty, but I do think that we're blessed to have our roadways and our drivers out there.
Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. The men and women that are out there every day trying to make our roads function, keep us safe on the roads, trying to do their best to balance peace. And we're very grateful for those things. Those are a couple of things. So maybe take them, if you're listening to this podcast, maybe you can go out to our Facebook page and just share something you're grateful for this weekend, the freedoms that you are enjoying, something that you want to just voice your thanks for. That'd be a great way to kind of continue this conversation. Let's talk just briefly about some updates that are happening around the organization, some operational changes and some regulatory things that are in place. I think the first thing that we want to make sure that we communicate is the FMCSA made some ruling adjustments around, or some allowances, I guess is probably a better way to say that, around CDL and medical card renewals. Obviously, with the current pandemic situation, getting some of those renewals processed timely, and even some facilities that have been closed, that's been a little bit of a challenge. So they're aware of that, and they've made some allowances to help support that. So systemically, in our dispatch software, we have made allowances to accommodate that. The ruling was that the expiration dates could be advanced out to September 30th. So if you had a CDL or medical card that was expiring before September 30th, what we did was, in the system, advance those dates to September 30th so that you could still be dispatchable and not have any issues operationally. So, however, it's also really important that we all understand it's our personal responsibility to get those documents renewed, recertified as appropriate. So if it's expired, you're strongly encouraged to do your best to get those licenses renewed, those medical cards recertified for another period, because come September 30th, under the current guidelines, this allowance will be removed. So if you have a document that's expiring, I would strongly encourage you to do your best to try and get that renewed. But I do want to bring it to your attention that we are aware of that guideline change and have made some adjustments in the system to hopefully limit the impact that that actually has on us operationally.
All right. And just for a platform science update, I want to give a shout out to those teams on the ground that have kept us installing and implementing across the country, even during this slowdown. Currently, we have 815 units live.
That's awesome.
I know. So we've our technology team has continued to work hard. We have our shops and maintenance staff installing for us, as well as third-party vendors where it's necessary. And our safety team is out there working hard to get our drivers trained. So this past weekend, we finished Norfolk, Virginia, as well as a couple locations in the Carolinas, Cowpens and Spartanburg and Florence, South Carolina. Coming up, we are going to finish our Cleveland, Tennessee location. So that's a big one. Phoenix, Arizona has continued to do some installations, and they will continue about 300 units in that area. That's a big one. Coming up the next 8 weeks, we have a plan for the Atlanta, Derry, Bluffton, and we're going to roll into several other locations, Delaware. So we're busy for the next 8 weeks.
Yeah. The platform science is going well. Appreciate all the driver feedback we've gotten there, and patience as you learn new things. And hopefully you've heard some good things about that driver response thus far. It's been really encouraging. So we're excited to bring that to a city near you soon. And we'll keep you posted with the timelines and that. You'll see additional training and, you know, materials on the display screens in the offices and things like that to make you aware of what's coming.
Drivers have really, really had positive feedback. It is change, but one of our core values is embrace change. So we are for sure going down that path right now, but drivers have really taken to it. So we're proud.
Yeah, having been a part of this company for 20 years, I can say I'm very, very encouraged at the way our driver community is responding to this particular change. All change is hard. I recognize that. But drivers overwhelmingly have embraced this change really as a reality of progress, which is, it is, as Rebecca said, one of our core values. So I just want to say thanks for those of you that already made the transition. Grateful for that. For those of you that are coming down the road, you know, it's ahead of you. Just know that we're working hard to make that transition as smooth as possible, and just have a positive attitude going into it. And we think you'll find something beneficial there as well.
As always, we want your feedback, so please make sure you reach out to us and let us know if you have any questions. Already, we've received some great call-in and questions, and we will certainly answer those on future podcasts. So the information to call in.
Yeah, to get your questions into us, there's two ways you can really go about doing that. One is inside the mobile app. If you go to the podcast feature of the mobile app, there's a button at the top that says Ask. Just tap that button. It'll place a call for you. If for some reason you don't have access to that right now, you can always give us a call. It's 615-257-9905. 615-257-9905. And like Rebecca said, we'll do our best to take on as many questions as we can in the upcoming podcasts. Okay, I think we'll just sign off with just saying, you know, blessings to you this weekend. We hope you have a great 4th of July. Thankful for all your hard work. I'm going to go listen to some Lee Greenwood maybe and grill a few things and just try to be thankful for this great nation. Thank you.
Thank you.